In this lesson, we're going to discuss the many ways that we can invert masks and have just a little bit more control over what we're masking. So in a previous lesson, we were able to select something in our file and apply a mask. So if something's selected, you have learned that you can mask a selection and it will create that mask. Now, in some instances, you may want to be able to invert the selection or invert the mask. So I'll show you several different ways that we can do this. The first way is to basically go up to the select menu and choose to inverse your selection. And you'll notice what happens is the selection is the opposite. So now when we go to mask, it basically creates the opposite type of mask. So that method is just basically inverting or inversing our selection. Okay. That's one method. We will go through just a couple different ways that we can do this. Now the next method, if I select something and I hold down the Option key and create a mask, it does the same thing. It creates the inverted version of a mask. Okay, so if we did not hold down Option, we would have this. However, if we hold Option, we have this. So it's a quick and easy way to be able to mask something really quickly. Again, that shortcut that you would hold down when you create that is just Option and then apply or add the layer mask to your layer. Okay, now there are times where you may have masked something and you may decide that you want to be able to switch the way the mask is positioned. So in this example, you know, the black is revealing the layer beneath, which is this pink layer. And then the white is keeping our rainbow layer. Now, if you ever want to invert a mask after it's been created, you would basically hold down Command and I, and it would switch it automatically. And if you want it to come back and turn to the other version, you would hit Command I to invert it again. This also works and is very useful when you're first applying masks. It's very common. You may apply the mask, nothing happens. If you hit Command I, it fills it with the black color on the mask, so that now if we were to decide to paint with white, it reveals that layer beneath. Okay, now there's one other method, and again, there's always several different ways that we can go about doing things in Photoshop. In this method, we'll go ahead and apply our mask, and we're going to hold down Shift and Delete. And when we do, what that does is basically allows us to fill our mask, because our mask is what's activated. So in this case, we could choose to fill this with black or really any color, but because masks work in grayscale, it's only really going to apply a black value. So black, gray, or white. And in this case, we can say okay, and then it fills it with black. So those are multiple different ways that we can invert or inverse our selections as well as our masks in Photoshop, so that you have a lot more control over your mask and you can do a lot more creative things.